But yeah, you, what happened with the Brazzers contract? And I mean, what happened there?
I don't think that I was ever actually going to do it. I was like breaking up with my husband. Like I was feeling bored in life, kind of like the dancing thing. And they like offered me all this money and like all this stuff. And like, I was just like, this seems like it'll be exciting and offer like a spice to my life. But also because I have that issue with like body fluids and I just don't really want to have sex with a bunch of like random people, I guess.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I don't think I actually would have been able to do it, honestly.
She has this strange anxiety that I guess came about recently of body fluids. I don't understand how you went from like being so over comfortable with it and just cool with anything to a point where you don't want it anywhere near you now. Because I've
seen some of the most disgusting cum shots. Like,
what you have talked about these. You had one that looked like mashed potatoes, I think you said. Yeah.
No, it was like boogers. And luckily it didn't land on me. It was a scene with two other girls. It was a VR scene and we were sitting on like a rock in a pool and he was supposed to come on our faces. And luckily it didn't get on me, but I just saw it on the other girls and I started gagging.
You got post-traumatic.
Yeah, and I think that was the point where I was PTCD. Like, I don't PTCD. Want cum in my mouth anymore or on my face. And I think I started like dodging it at that point.
Imagine being the actor, the male actor, and like you've always had willing participants. And now you have this like person that's like playing Frogger. They're like, bloop, bloop, bloop. Gotta be faster than that. Just cum shots are just shooting all over the place, missing.
And I think
it's Asteroids, bro. You know the game Asteroids? <Yeah. laughs>
I think people started noticing too because they were like, why isn't Lana letting it get in her mouth anymore?
Whoa.
Yeah. Whoa. Wow.
That's his reaction when he quite literally has no idea what the fuck to say to something like that.
Whoa, dude.
I don't know. That's crazy.
And I'm also looking over at the one day when our sound guy who monitors what's said on this podcast isn't here to listen and Danny is just listening to all of
our,
this.
Our Christian. Sweet, pure
virgin
Danny.
Danny.
And this was a great day to have Danny do it, guys.